Good morning, student. Today we'll start kinetic molecular theory of gases. This theory tells that assumptions, there are some assumptions in this theory, that the particles are far away from one another. If, for example, gaseous particles remains far away from one another, so their volume compared to the volume of the container is nearly zero. This is assumption one. Assumption two, since the particles are far away from one another, there is no force of attraction between those particles. The attraction between the particles is also zero. This is the second postulate. Third postulate is that a particle can move randomly. So particle have random movement. Now when the particle move randomly, the one particle, there is a chance that one particle collide with another particle, and this collision is taken as perfectly elastic. Means there is no loss of energy during that collision, loss or gain of energy. Next, if there are lots of particles, different particles having different kinetic energy. So this law is different particles having different kinetic energy. So in order to solve that one, different particle, different kinetic energy, we have to talk about the average kinetic energy, which is proportional to the temperature. So these are the laws of your kinetic molecular theory of gases. Now, after these laws, we have to learn behavior of real gases and deviation from ideal gas behavior, ideal gasification. Now, behavior of real gases, we know that PV equal to nRT, if this part remains constant, so PV equal to constant, and graph for a constant is straight line. This is for your ideal gas. Now PV versus P diagram we are drawing, but we find that the graphs are actually looks like that. So different gases showing the deviation from the ideal gas equation. Why those kind of graphs are there, that you require to be explained. So this is for helium, this is for hydrogen, this is for CH4, this is for CO. Below those, these are called negative deviation. Above, these are called your positive deviation. Now, this cannot be explained by ideal gas behavior. So now there is a demand to define the another gas. This is called real gas. A gas which does not obey Boyle's law, Charles' law, and Avogadro's law are called real gases. Now, why this deviation? What is the main reason behind this deviation? The deviation answer is in the kinetic molecular theory of gas. In kinetic molecular theory, two assumptions we have taken, there is wrong assumption. Assumption number one is volume is zero. Assumption number two, attraction is zero. although the gas particles having less volume, but volume should be considered. So if this is a container and gas particles, if you consider all the particles here, so if there is n number of particles with volume V, so we have the formula PV equal to nRT. In that case, volume correction, this V become V minus nV, means particles having less volume. Earlier we have considered the for a particle there is whole room is the volume, but now you have to subtract that one. So in another case, in pressure correction, if a particle, earlier we have considered that this is the pressure, but this pressure we have considered earlier, it is 80% actually, because the particles are attracted by the other particles which reduce its speed of attraction to strike the wall. So this is pressure correction. You have to do P plus N square by V square P minus NV equal to nRT. This equation is called your real gas equation. Now this real gas equation for n equal to 1, that become P plus A by V square V minus V is equal to RT. So where is the A and B are the called van der Waals coefficient. A is called your van der Waals coefficient for attraction. For example, A is tends to be 0 for hydrogen and helium. Now if A is 0, your P plus 0 V minus B equal to RT, or PB equal to RT plus PB. In that case, PB is greater than RT, PB by RT greater than 1. And this PB by RT is called Z greater than 1. Z is PB by RT. And name of Z is your compressibility factor. So Z is greater than 1, which is shown by the graph that Z is greater than 1 here. So actually, student, you have up to this in this chapter, you have syllabus. You try to solve the numericals of this chapter. Thank you.